Italy since September has a new government. On the base of some failure from the past, we decided our party to join this coalition to stabilize the country. Budget law that was serious in terms of reorganizing the main economic line, and now starting the second phase, that is investment, specializing ourselves on the Green Deal. So we have many projects going on. Of course, in this coalition, there is party like the Five Stars that decided to open a reflection on their organization towards a general assembly they are going to do in March. Minister Luigi Di Maio, that was the leader that brought the party to great success, now decided to help this renewal internal discussion. So I feel sorry for him, because we are friends, but I think that he did it in order to stabilize the party and also to stabilize the government.
I understand that, but you're also a coalition of two completely angles, a coalition of odd sorts to begin with. Can it continue when one of your partners is undergoing so much turmoil? We've had defections from the party, some ministers have even, we've had resignations from the cabinet, we've had people leave to go to Lega. How can you survive when your coalition partner is undergoing so much turmoil?
This is an ongoing discussion in terms of what we have to do. As you know, September was an anomalous moment, because this is a result of a coalition that came out from a crisis of the former government. So we are based on what to do for the country. Until we receive all the input from the parliament, and we have a large majority, because even if some MEP went out from the party, they are still supporting the government, we are targeting ourselves on investment, growth, reform. Until the government perform all this result, I think that optimistically we can realize what's the program on the base of the government.
Okay, so you're going to try to keep the coalition together to realize some of those plans. But more imminently, we have regional elections coming up this weekend. Emilia Romagna.
In two days, exactly.
It's a very tight race between PD and Lega. And it's essentially what people are talking about. It's become a referendum on the coalition government. If PD lose to Lega, doesn't that tell you that inevitably the public want a general election?
I must say that these two elections, Emilia Romagna and Calabria, are regional one.
It's been a stronghold for PD for a very long time.
It's a historical one, but we have a strong candidate that has a head and has good result outcome out of the years of government. So we are confident that it's going to convince the people and to have their trust for another term. Of course, this could have some effect on the political debate, but in terms of government going on, we are stable, we are concretely oriented to perform reform, investment and growth. I think this the country needs. We have the number in the parliament to do it.
Hi, I'm Giovanna Bersecci, and thank you for watching. You can check out more of our videos by clicking on the boxes on the screen. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more from CNBC International. Thank you for watching.